where do I begin and end with this fucking movie? So Resident Evil, the final chapter, is supposedly slash finally slash hopefully the very last Resident Evil movie in existence. I mean, fingers crossed. This movie stars Mila Jovovich once again and is directed by Paul W.F. Anderson, who is like the greatest director this side of a baboon's butthole. The only way to describe what this movie is okay, is Alice has to do certain things to save the world, and when she goes to do certain things, action happens. I'm not exaggerating. That's literally the story for the movie, is that Alice has to do stuff and action, and that's it. Oh, January, you are not going down without a fight, I see. Good for you. Wait, was there anything I liked about this movie? I guess Mia Djokovic is trying sometimes. Oh my god, what a shit show. Okay, you know what this movie actually is? Okay, this movie is just a bunch of action bullshit happening for the sake of action bullshit happening. There's no rhyme, there's no reason for anything to be happening in this movie. I mean, multiple times action is happening in this movie, like, every 2 or 3 minutes. And literally, I'm just sitting there like, okay, why are we doing this? What's going on? Seriously, it's like every 3 minutes, there has to be something action-oriented happening. Does it matter if it fits with the story? Does it matter if it makes any sense? No, it's just we're gonna have action happen every 2 minutes because we have to fill some sort of imaginary quota. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if the studio went to the makers of this movie and was like, hey, well, you know, we have to keep the people interested, so every 2 minutes you have to have a stupid ass action scene that makes no sense. Otherwise, we're gonna take money out of your wallets. Do you want that? Do you really want that? And the makers of this movie go, shit, not my wallet. Nope, come on, let's action this shit up. You know what? That could be perfectly fine, I suppose, if you just wanted a dumb disposable action movie. The problem is that the action sequences in this film are edited and shot to complete shit. Oh my god, I had a headache and I had an eye twitch and I couldn't see straight for like 3 hours after watching this movie. So many different flashing lights and just random cuts and a bunch of shaky cam bullshit. I kid you not, this is how most of the action sequences in this movie are like. And you know what? I could even deal with the shaky cam a little bit if there didn't have to be like 7 to 8 to 10 to 12 to 14 to 20 to 25 different cuts every half second. I haven't been this confused and irritated during an action scene since Columbiana. Yeah, the scene where Zoe Saldana is fighting some dude in a bathroom and I think she maybe shoved a toothbrush up a guy's ass. I can't remember because I couldn't see what the fuck was going on. When someone gets hit or someone falls down, I'm just assuming that something happened. Not because I actually saw it, but just because I heard a noise and all of a sudden the person's on the ground. But the action sequences in this movie are so shit that I think on one particular part, one of the characters gave another character a wedgie. I'm not entirely sure because I don't know what the hell I saw because I couldn't tell what the hell I was watching for most of this movie. Oh, you're on the ground now. Well, I'm assuming that someone hit you. Well, there's no point in mentioning the story or the characters because there are no story or characters in this movie. What? Mila Jovovich has her I'm trying to get a paycheck face on for most of the movie. Towards the end, there's so much illogical, stupid-ass bullshit just starts happening in the story where they actually try to have some semblance of a story at the end. I know what they're doing, by the way. It's really clever. They're trying to have shit happen in this movie so fast that you don't go back and actually think about what it is you just saw. They want to skim over it so that you're just entertained by the mindless action so that you don't have a brain and you just kind of let it go. But once my senses cleared and once my eyes stopped messing with me and once my headache went away a little bit, I actually started to think about shit at the end of this movie. I'm like, well, no, that doesn't make sense. That's stupid. That doesn't make sense. Why did I even watch this? Oh my god, and the movie shouldn't even be called The Final Chapter. It insinuates that this is the last Resident Evil movie, right? Alice even says during the movie that this is how my story ends. Does her story end? Kinda. The movie actually should be called Resident Evil The Final Chapter. Unless our box office does pretty well, then we'll see you again in 3 years. In 3 years, if another one of these things comes out, I'm going into the movie theater with middle finger stuck on fuck, because I just don't care anymore. I got the perfect title for you, Resident Evil. You ready for it? It's Resident Evil, A Quest for Peace. Well, that's one more for the shit list at the end of the year. But at least January is over. Thank God. Alright guys, so what is your favorite live-action zombie movie? Go ahead and let me know down in the comments below. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter, at SuperFanHM. As usual, if you like what you see, tell me how you feel, and stay tuned to hear more from the Man of Steel. Have fun this weekend, guys. Peace.